In this video, we will continue our natural selection theory and we will study about the examples of the natural selection. Examples of natural selection. The first example that we will study in the natural selection is of industrial millennialism. This industrial millennialism we have also studied in the previous videos under the heads of types of natural selection, under that in the directional selection. So, we will continue the example of the industrial millennialism. This was first given by or first studied by the scientist Fisher and Ford. These both scientists studied this industrial millennialism. So, what they studied in that we will discuss here. In the early 19th century, there was no industries or there was no industrial growth in England. No industrial growth in England, specifically in the place named Birmingham. In earlier 19th centuries, there were no industrial growth in England, specifically on the place or specifically in the place Birmingham. So, when there was no industrial growth in England, there was the one variety of moth was present, that was light or grey colored moth. Light or grey colored moth, they were present in plenty or they were more in population. So, what is the reason behind the more in number of these light colored moth? Because as I said that there was no industrial growth. So, when there is no pollution, so we can say that or we know that the lichens are the indicators of the pollution. When there is a pollution in the environment, there is no growth of lichens. And when the environment is pollution free, lichens can grow or lichens can develop everywhere. So, when there was no industries in England, there was the growth of lichens there. Growth of lichens, and these lichens are also grey in color. There was no industries and they were having the number of these grey colored moth or the light colored moth. And due to the no pollution in the environment, the lichens were growing or developing everywhere. Mostly they were developing on the barks of the trees and on the surface or the walls of the buildings. They were growing mostly there on the barks of the trees as well as on the surface of the buildings, outer surface of the buildings. So, these grey colored moth, when they experience any kind of danger from their predators, they used to match up themselves with these lichens or they used to sit on the bark of that trees to match up with this or to blend or to show camouflage with the background, with these grey colored or light colored of backgrounds. So, they were not easily noticeable by their predators and this light colored moth, the scientific name of this light colored moth is Biston Betularia. So this light colored moth were more in number due to the reason they can blend with the background, or they can show the camouflage with the background, and this light and light color they get matched up, and they were not easily noticeable by the predators. And on the other hand, there was also the population of one dark colored moth, but they were less in number and their scientific name is the same, Biston, but here there is the name of light colored moth is Betularia and the dark colored moth name is Biston Carbonaria. Biston Betularia and Biston Carbonaria, the name of the scientific name of the dark colored moth. So light colored moth were present in plenty and dark colored moth was present in less number, because the light colored moth they can show camouflage with their lighter background, and due to the Biston Carbonaria they were dark in color, so they were easily noticeable by the predators. वो predators के द्वारा जल्दी से notice हो जाते थे, वो predators के द्वारा जल्दी से पकड़े जा सकते थे. क्यों? Why? Because they cannot match up with the background. The background was light in color and the Biston Carbonaria or the dark colored moth, they were black in color somewhat or dark in color. So they were easily noticeable by the predators. At that time the population of the Biston Carbonaria was less due to no industrialization, when the phase of no industries growth. But when the situation changed, in this situation when there was no industrialization, the fittest species was the light colored moth or the Biston Betularia, because they can survive at that time in that situation. Kaisa bhi ho, they were favored by environment, they can live in that situation, so their population was increasing and they were being selected by the nature as the fittest species. So this was the at that time the light colored moth were the fittest species according to the nature, so they were selected by the nature. And on the other hand, these were not adapted or well suited to the environment. The Biston Carbonaria that were not well suited to the environment, therefore they were not selected by the environment. But when the situation changed, when the phase of industrialization started, when the phase of industrialization started, so at that time what happened, due to the growth of industries the pollution started in the environment started polluting. And what was the main cause of that pollution? Smoke. And in that smoke the carbon is the main constituent. So when the phase of industrialization started, environment start polluting and the smoke present in the environment. So when the smoke was present in the environment, the main constituent of this smoke is carbon. So when the phase of industrialization started, the carbon entered into the environment. So due to the presence of carbon in the smoke, now there is pollution in the environment, So lichens are the indicators of pollution. Now due to the pollution, the lichens start disappearing from the environment, or the carbon, that smoky carbon, started covering the barks and covering the surface of the buildings, and lichens started disappearing. So ab lichens disappear hona start ho gaye hain, and all that things which were covered at that time by lichens, now all that things are being covered by the smoke or by the soot, we can say. So when all these things were being covered by the smoke, then the color of the background is now black, smoke in the environment, and color of background is now black. So ab environment ka aur the background ka color ab black ho gaya hai. Now this situation, the background which is black in color, this situation will be favored, or this is the favorable situation for the Bristol carbonaria. So ab jab pura environment aur pura jo background hai, that is become darker in color, then the population of Bristol carbonaria is increased, and population of Bristol Betularia is decreased. Here there was no industrial growth. Here when there was the industrial growth started, when there was no industrial growth, there was no pollution, no smoke in the environment, the whole background was covered by the lichens, and because the lichens are light in color, so they used to favor the more population of the light colored moth. Because light colored moth were being favored at that time, so they started reproducing and their number also increased. And in the phase of industrialization, the whole background was black in color, so the darker species or the Bristol carbonaria was favored at that time, because they were not easily now noticeable by the predators, and the light colored species was easily noticeable. So the dark colored was favored in this situation, and they started reproducing and increased their number. So in this situation, this darker species was the fittest species or the fittest individual, and it was selected by the nature because it was the best suited or the best adapted species according to nature. And the species which is best adapted or best suited, and whose survival rate is more, that will be selected by the nature. This was the law of natural selection. So this is what incident which happened in the environment. The one scientist, his name was Kettlewood. He artificially performed the industrial melanism. Artificially performed industrial melanism. What he did, he introduced the same number of the light colored moth and the same number of the dark colored moth in the environment where there was no pollution. In the same region in England, in Birmingham, where there is no pollution and no human habitat or no human activity was there, say as in the forest where there was no industrial growth, no such pollution or human habitat is present, he introduced the same number of both the species, the lighter one also and the darker one also. He introduced the same number of species in that forest. And what he did? He also introduced the same number of both the species in the polluted area. He introduced the same number of both the darker and lighter species in polluted area and pollution free area. He introduced the same number of species in both this area. After some time, what he observed that in the polluted area, he got the results same as that what here was studied by Fisher and Ford, that in the polluted area more population will be of the Biston carbon area. In the polluted area more population of Biston carbon area and less of Biston Bitul area, and in the pollution free area the same, that more number of Biston Bitul area and less number of Biston carbon area. So he was quite satisfied with this result, that he was getting the similar result what has actually happened in the nature. And when he did his experiment by introducing the same number of both the species in the different areas, where in the one area there was no pollution and in the another area which was full of pollution, he got the same results, that in the polluted area the number of Biston Bitul area, Biston carbon area was more than the number of Biston Bitul area, and in the pollution free area where there was no pollution, no industrial growth, there were lichens. So due to the presence of lichens in that area, the Biston Bitul area was favored. He got the same results. And here the term industrial melanism, why it was given the term industrial melanism? It was given to this incident where when there was no industries in England, so here the light colored moth was favored, and when the situation changed, so here the dark colored moth was being favored. So the organism or koi bhi organism perfectly fit nahi hota ya pehle se wo fit nahi hota hai, he becomes fit when he is or it is adapted to that situation or adapted to that environment. वो तभी फिट हो पाएगा जब वो उस एनवायरनमेंट में अडैप्ट हो जाएगा या वो उस एनवायरनमेंट में जीना सीख लेगा. देन दैट ऑर्गेनिज्म विल बी कॉल्ड एज द फिटेस्ट ऑर्गेनिज्म, क्योंकि उसने खुद को उस एनवायरनमेंट में इतना अडैप्ट कर लिया है, या फिर हम कह सकते हैं कि उसने उस एनवायरनमेंट में जीना सीख लिया है, अब खुद को उस तरीके से बना लिया है, that it is to be called as fittest species, and it will only be the species that will be selected by the nature. This was the example of, we were studying the example of natural selection of industrial melanism. Now we will study a few more examples of the natural selection. The next example under the head examples of natural selection we are going to study is pest resistance in mosquitoes, or we can say that DDT resistance in the mosquitoes. DDT resistance in mosquitoes. So DDT was not earlier used, it was came in use in the year or around 1940 or 1950s. DDT came in use. So why DDT came in use? Because at that time mosquitoes population were increasing at a rapid rate or were increasing at a very high rate. So jab mosquitoes ka population bahut zyada higher rate se badh raha tha, so we know that the mosquitoes are responsible for causing the malaria, and the vector responsible for causing malaria is Plasmodium, and these vectors or the Plasmodium, they are responsible for the causing of malaria. And at that time the population of mosquitoes were increasing at a very high number. So to provide a check for the increasing population of the mosquitoes, the DDT was used. Though the DDT was a pesticide, DDT is a pesticide. Though it was a pesticide, it was showing good results in decreasing the population of the mosquitoes. When we were sprinkling the DDT over the mosquitoes and over the larvae, there was a good decrease in the population of the mosquitoes. Therefore, the DDT, though it was a pesticide, it was used to keep a check under the to keep a check in the population of the mosquitoes. Now, and we know that the vector which is responsible for causing malaria is Plasmodium. So when DDT was we know that there are some variations in the population according to Darwin, that hamesha kisi na kisi sari populations mein, we can say that in every population there exist some kind of variation. Har population mein koi na koi variations paaye jaate hain. To jab sari populations mein variation paaye jaate hain, to mosquitoes ki population mein bhi kuch variation honge. They were also having certain variations which were very useful for them. So in the population of mosquitoes, suppose this is the population of mosquitoes, and some species or some were having the variations. What was this variation? They were having the gene, or they were having that variation in which they were having the gene which provides resistance against DDT. This was the variation which was present in the population of the malaria, that they were having the gene which is providing them the resistance against the DDT. So when there was no use of DDT, or we can say that when DDT was not being used, so these variegated varieties of the mosquitoes, they were not having any advantage over the normal ones. When there was no use of DDT, the variation containing mosquitoes. They were not having any advantage over the normal ones. So, when DDT was not being used, they were not having any advantage over the normal ones. The situation was like this only. They were living together. But when the situation changed, when situation changed, when DDT was sprinkled over the mosquitoes. So, this is the population of mosquito and we are having some mosquitoes which are bearing the gene or which are having the gene which provides resistance against the DDT. So, this is the population of mosquitoes and these are the gene, these are the mosquitoes which are having the gene against the, for having the resistance against the DDT. When DDT was in use, so all these normal ones, they were being killed, all these normal mosquitoes were killed and only remaining were the mosquitoes which were having the variation or which was having the resistance against the DDT. So, the normal ones were died and the remaining one, the resistance one, they started to reproduce. When they started reproducing, their number increases. So, after some time, kya hua? Pehle jab DDT use mein nahi tha, all were same. The normal ones were also living together, the normal ones and the variegated one, all the were same. And the mosquitoes which were having the gene for the resistance against the DDT, they were not having any kind of advantage over the normal ones. Par jab situation change hui, jab atmosphere badla, so only that variety is able to live which is having the variation or which is having that variation which is favorable for that species. Uske paas wo variation tha jo uski jeevan ke liye favorable tha. So, because of that variation, that species was selected by the nature as the fittest species. क्योंकि उसके पास में कुछ ऐसा कैरेक्टर था, कुछ ऐसा ट्रेट था, जिसकी वजह से नेचर ने उसे सिलेक्ट किया. And because of the selection of nature or because of the presence of that variation, these mosquitoes were survived. And after some time, they started reproducing and increased their number. So, यहाँ पर जब when there was no use of DDT, all were normal, but jab situation change hui, the only species was remaining which was having some variation into it or which was selected by the nature. So, this was the second example of DDT resistance in the mosquitoes. The third example which we will take is of antibiotic resistance in bacteria. Third example, antibiotic resistance in the bacteria. We know that bacteria are also responsible for certain kind of diseases and all these things. And we have done this or this experiment One experiment was done to show the antibiotic resistance of bacteria that was done by Lederberg and Lederberg. So what they told, they cultured the bacterial population by providing the nutrient medium to that bacterial population. And again and again they form the replica plate of that bacterial population by providing the same medium to that bacteria. He cultured the same population. He took some of the bacteria from the master plate and he started growing the bacteria again in the another container. And this was done several times. And in the last one, what they did, they mix the nutritional mixture or the nutritional medium with one antibiotic. And what they observed in that, some of the bacteria were survived and some of the bacteria were lost. So here we will study about that experiment. So what Lederberg and Lederberg, what they did, they took one petri dish and they put the nutritive medium in that. Generally we use the nutritive medium for growing the bacterial population is agar. So they also took the nutrition medium agar for making the colonies of the bacteria or for culturing the bacteria in the petri dish. This is petri dish and they use the nutrient medium agar for developing the bacteria. They put some bacteria into it and with the help of nutrition agar they started multiplying or they started dividing and increasing their population. Many types of bacteria were introduced into this plate and they started making their colonies. So this was the appearance of that plate in which the they had cultured their bacteria by taking the nutrient medium agar, and they have to make a copy of that. So in the another petri dish they took one more petri dish and put the same nutritive medium agar. They also they put the same nutritive medium agar in the next petri dish also. And now they wanted to transfer these bacteria into this one. So how will they transfer? For this they were using one technique. They were having one wooden plank. It was like this. They were having one wooden plank in this shape and they covered the surface of wooden plank with the velvet cloth. This was the wooden plank what they were going to use to transfer the bacteria from this petri dish to the this petri dish. They were going to use this wooden plank and they had covered the surface of this wooden plank with the velvet cloth. Now what they did, they just took this wooden plank and dipped into this petri dish and just touched the surface of this nutrient medium. So what happened by doing this, when they dipped this wooden plank into the first petri dish, so some of the bacteria were sticked to the surface of the velvet cloth and the sticked bacteria when they touched the surface of this nutrient medium, they were lent into that nutrient medium or into the nutrient medium of the second petri dish. So this type of transference of the bacteria from one nutritive plate or from one petri dish to the another petri dish is called as inoculation. So basically they were inoculating the bacteria from one petri dish to the another petri dish, and this one is called as master plate because it was the first plate in which they were growing the colonies of bacteria, and from this plate only they were making different plates also. So now they introduced some of the or inoculated some of the bacteria from the first plate or from the master plate to the second plate. So after some time they observed the same thing, that some bacteria started making colonies into it because they were getting the proper nutrient medium. So they started making colonies in the second petri dish also. Now this plate is the replica of this plate, that both are the same. They have just inoculated some of the bacteria from this plate and lend it to that plate. So these both are replica plate, they both are the same. It have been originated from this master plate only. So they are called as replica plate. And in the next time what they did, they again took one petri dish and they put agar with penicillin, antibiotic penicillin. Here what they had in nutrient medium, agar and penicillin antibiotic. And again they did the same thing, they just put this wooden plank into the master plate, inoculated the bacteria and lent it into the third petri dish. So now he observed or they observed that some of the bacteria were growing as it is, that some bacteria were growing colonies in this culture also. See the difference, that here this species has grown equally. The blue one, they were also growing equally in both of these places, but they are few in number in this, and the orange one, they were same in this and they are few in this. So from this they observed that some of the species or some of the bacteria which are growing, they were having resistance towards that particular antibiotic. Unke paas mein us antibiotic ke liye resistance power hai, therefore they are able to live in that or able to grow in that particular antibiotic. And the others that which were killed or that were not surviving in that environment, they were not having any kind of resistance towards this antibiotic, therefore they were killed. So this experiment where the same type of bacteria were being inoculated in and forming and they were forming the replica plate, therefore this experiment is also called as Lederberg replica plating experiment. Lederberg replica plating experiment. Why? Because they were forming the replica plates and they were inoculating the bacteria from the master plate to the next plate, and in the last plate what they did, they mixed the nutrient medium agar with the antibiotic penicillin, and what they observed, that some of the bacteria were survived and some of the bacteria were killed. the bacterias which were survived, they were having the antibiotic resistance, or they were having the variation or the gene which was showing resistant against the antibiotic, and the others which were killed, they were normal, and so they were they don't survive. So in the normal situation, in this both plates also, the bacterias will be were present which were having the gene resistant property. In both plate also they were present, but in the normal situation they were not getting any kind of advantage over that. But when the situation was changed, or when they make the situation more severe for these bacteria to survive, only that bacteria were survived which can adapt into that environment, which were best suited to that type of environment, they were only survived and the others were killed. So this was the third example of bacteria, antibiotic resistance in the bacteria, in which the two scientists Lederberg and Lederberg performed the experiment, and their experiment is called as Lederberg replica plating experiment. It is very important according to the exam point of view, so we can remember this. Isme yaad rakhne wali cheez kya hai, that they had made three replica plates, and in the last one they had mixed the agar and the penicillin. This come under the category antibiotic resistance in the bacteria, and the name of the experiment, the Lederberg replica plating experiment. So this were the three examples of natural selection. We will also study some more examples of natural selection.